Mr. Camus, from the time you started to try to find the tapes that contain the emails, how long did it actually take you to find them?
Literally about 2 weeks.
So despite everything that the IRS said, from the time you started to the time you found them was about 2 weeks.
Correct.
When you showed up and talked to the IT people and said, well, what's happened here? What did they tell you?
They cooperated and answered our questions fully.
Had anybody ever asked them for the tapes?
No.
So we send a subpoena, we send letters, we have hearings, we hear all kinds of excuses from the IRS. They can't have them, they're recycled, they've been destroyed, they're not available, we can't find... I mean, every excuse you can have under the sun, you start, you find them in 2 weeks, and then when you go talk to the IT people who are there in charge of them, they told you that they were never even asked for them? Is that correct?
That's correct.
Are there potentially even more tapes?
We found the new population of tapes literally 2 weeks ago. We believe those were the 2011 tapes.
So you learn like the whole world, and then as the chairman said, 15 days later, you find them. How'd you find them?
We asked for them, and we demanded them.
But I mean, how'd you actually get the physical tapes? What'd you do?
Well, we identified the IRS experts that would know where the tapes are. We interviewed them, and we obtained them.
You get in the car and drive to Martinburg, West Virginia?
That's correct.
Yeah, you just got in the car, we drove to the place that had the tapes, you said, can we see the tapes? Here they are. Yeah. So you just did something pretty simple. Where are the tapes? I'm going to get in the car, I'm going to drive, and I'm going to get the tapes. Are these the only tapes you've got?
No, we 2 weeks ago, we recovered an additional 424 tapes.
How'd you find out about these tapes?
As we were following up on our initial interviews, we realized that we were missing a document. When we obtained that document and reviewed it, we realized that there were an additional population of tapes that had been unaccounted for.
So missing a document, whose document was that and who should have given you that document?
It was an IRS document.
They didn't give you a document, and by not having the document, you couldn't figure out that there were more tapes out there with potentially more Lois Lerner emails on them. Is that correct?
That would be accurate.
Yeah. So any concerns about the fact that that document wasn't there? And how did you figure out that the document was missing?
Just following up, as we're coming down to the conclusion in our investigation, we make sure we have all the documents. So when we determined that we were short one document, we went and demanded it, and we obtained it. Then we were able to notice that there were a population of tapes that had never been disclosed.
And where were those tapes? Same place?
They were also in Martinsburg.
So you got in the car and drove there again, right?
Yes, we did.
You got more tapes?
We did.
Amazing.
Where the emails were being stored, was it in somewhat of a unique place, or was it standard that you would expect for them to be here?
Where they were, the 744 tapes that we initially obtained on July 1st were in the backup system of the IRS Microsoft Exchange server. So they were right where you would expect them to be.
Right where you were expecting them to be.
And when we demanded them to fit that period, that's what was supplied to us. Only until 2 weeks ago did we find out that probably the tapes that we are actually looking for, we were never told about, if that makes sense.
So when the chairman asked the important question, is there potentially criminal activity here? Your answer was?
There is potential criminal activity.
We have been patient. We have asked. We have issued subpoenas. We have held hearings. Ways and Means, Senate Finance, House Oversight and Government Reform. It's just shocking to me that you start, 2 weeks later, you're able to find the emails. We go and talk to the people who are in charge of this, and nobody even asked them for the tapes. I got to tell you, I really do appreciate the great work that you are doing on this. You know, the ranking member, I got the greatest respect for him, and he cited some statistics that I believe were given to him by the IRS. 250 employees and thousands of hours and all this. But the one thing that we're trying to get to, and nobody even asked him for it. Didn't even ask. I'll yield back. Recognize the ranking member.